The Philippine Deposit Receipts, or PDRs, of ABS-CBN, which are issued to foreign investors, are completely compliant with the Constitution and do not constitute a scheme to circumvent the constitutional requirement on 100% Filipino ownership and management of mass media enterprises. The criticism that PDRs achieve indirectly what the Constitution directly prohibits is regrettably utterly baseless speculation. There is no need to invoke the piercing of the veil of corporate fiction with respect to PDRs because, one, there is nothing secret or furtive about the issuance of PDRs, as the issuance is permitted both by the Securities and Exchange Commission and the Philippine Stock Exchange for public transactions. Two, the relation of ABS-CBN Holdings Corporation and ABS-CBN Corporation are open and made public. ABS-CBN Holdings is the issuer of PDRs over the shares of ABS-CBN owned by it as underlying shares. There is nothing illegal or irregular about this. Three, to reiterate, the PDRs are not used to avoid or circumvent the pertinent provisions of the Constitution. They are compliant with Section 11.1 of Article 16 of the Constitution. Also, there is no need to make a distinction between American depository receipts and the Philippine deposit receipts, based on the difference that in the U.S., unlike in the Philippines, no corporation has a nationality or citizenship requirement, because both the American depository receipt and the Philippine deposit receipt are instruments of investment, not infusion of capital. In other words, the corporate ownership is not affected by the investments of holders of American depository receipts and Philippine deposit receipts upon the issuance of the deposit receipts, whether American or Philippine. It is not surprising that majority of those who purchase PDRs are foreigners, because PDRs were available in the Philippine setting after the late 1980s financial crisis, principally to secure foreign investments because the traditional source of financing were not anymore available. Also, the right of an alien PDR holder is limited to his ownership of the PDR. For example, his right to fruits or cash distribution, as well as option to have the underlying shares to which he is not entitled to own, sold in the stock market, and receive the proceeds of the sale. PDR holders are not stockholders because they have no voting rights and full beneficial ownership of a mass media corporation like ABS-CBN. Neither do they have title over the underlying shares. The Supreme Court ruled in Gamboa versus Tebes and reiterated in Roy versus Hermosa that, quote, control, unquote, with respect to nationalized businesses refers to, and I quote, shares with voting rights as well as full beneficial ownership, precisely because the right to vote in the election of directors coupled with full beneficial ownership of stock translates to effective control of a corporation, These Supreme Court decisions, although judicial interpretation of Section 11 of Article 12 on the 60-40 Filipino ownership of public utilities, apply by parity of constitutional intent to the requirement of 100% Filipino ownership and management for mass media under Section 11.1 of Article 16, which mandates, and I quote, the ownership and management. Let me underscore that ownership and management of mass media shall be limited to citizens of the Philippines or to corporations, cooperatives, or associations wholly owned and managed by such citizens. Without voting rights and title over the underlying shares, the PDR holders do not have ownership and management of ABS-CBN Corporation. The practice of issuing PDRs to secure investments is not an innovation of ABS-CBN because almost 100 years ago in the United States, American depository receipts were already part of the corporate practice to secure investments, not capital infusion, just like the European depository receipts of later vintage. In fact, GMA7 has its own PDRs, similar to ABS-CBN, which do not transfer control to the foreign holders of PDRs. The rights of PDR holders are limited to the following. One, receiving cash distribution consequent to the declaration of dividends accruing to the underlying shares of stock after the issuer, in this case, ABS-CBN Holdings, deducts cost of operation and payment of taxes. Two, option to convert the PDRs to shares of stock if they are qualified to own shares as Filipinos. And three, being ineligible, alien holders of PDRs can only receive the proceeds of the sale of the shares in the stock market. The stringent limitations on PDRs are stipulated in the following documents. One, PDR certificate. Two, PDR instrument. And three, PDR pledge agreement, wherein the pledger issuer retains ownership and voting rights over the underlying shares of the stock. The sale of ABS-CBN PDRs, let me repeat, is authorized both by the Securities and Exchange Commission and the Philippine Stock Exchange. Honorable Joint Chairman, no avalanche of adverse comments and speculative innuendos will alter the operative fact that PDRs are not vested with voting rights, ownership entitlements, or management prerogatives, and cannot be converted into shares of stock in favor of alien PDR holders. Thank you, Honorable Joint Chairman.